As we look ahead to 2040s, the future of aerial dominance promises to be defined by cutting-edge aircraft that blend advanced stealth, unmatched speed, and sophisticated technology. Innovations in artificial intelligence, electronic warfare, and weaponry will enable these new platforms to maintain superiority in increasingly complex and contested skies. Let's explore the aircraft likely to shape aerial dominance 15 to 20 years from now. The Su-57M. This will be an advancement based on the Su-57 5th generation stealth fighter. It will feature the third stage engine, SDLE-129, and will be equipped with radio-photonic radar ROFAR as its main sensor, capable of detecting and tracking targets, including stealth aircraft, at distances exceeding 500 kilometers. The first Su-57M is anticipated to enter service in 2030s. The aircraft will be fully networked with unmanned aerial vehicles using artificial intelligence to ensure seamless integration. The Su-75 Checkmate. Unveiled at the MAX 2021 airshow, it is a product of Russia's United Aerospace Company. Incorporating fifth-generation technologies, the aircraft is expected to have its first flight before 2030. Russia has a goal of producing 300 units over 15 years. Similar to other stealth aircraft, the Su-75 includes an internal weapons bay for missiles. The prototype's armament is comparable to that of the Su-35 and Su-57, as noted on exhibit information plaques. Mikoyan MiG-41 PAK-DP. This aircraft is set to replace the MiG-31 in the Russian Air Force by the mid-2030s. A key attribute of the MiG-41 is its stealth capability. Its designs aim to achieve cruising speeds above Mach 3, roughly 2,300 miles per hour, enabling rapid coverage of Russia's vast territory. This high speed may be paired with an anti-missile laser system to bolster its defensive measures. The PAK-DP is also intended to intercept hypersonic missiles and is equipped to carry anti-satellite missiles, highlighting its versatility in countering various modern threats. The TAI-TF Khan. This is a Turkish 5th-generation twin-engine multi-role fighter designed for stealth and all-weather operations. It aims to replace the Turkish Air Force's F-16 Fighting Falcons and is also intended for export. The TFX fighter is expected to become operational in the 2030s. BAE Systems is a key subcontractor in the project. Initially, prototypes will use General Electric F-110 engines until engines developed by TM Motor are available. The Flick System 2020. The program by the Swedish Air Force aims to develop a 5th-generation low-observable fighter jet by 2035. Public details about the project are scarce, and there have been no official updates on its progress. A video hints at prototype test, while the SAP or Linköping University generic future fighter project acts as a technology testbed. Despite the general knowledge of stealth concepts, the specific details of the aircraft are likely to remain confidential, with only the purchasing air forces have full insight into its capabilities. The Rafale F5 generation. The concept of the Rafale F5, also known as the Super Rafale, has been discussed since 2021. A Rafale F5 standard is now planned for introduction between 2035 and 2038. The F5 is expected to enhance connectivity and improve manned or unmanned teaming capabilities. It will also be equipped to carry the new ASN-4G hypersonic ramjet missile, which will replace the ASMPA missile and ensure the continuation of the airborne component of France's nuclear deterrent. Eurofighter EK. This is an electronic warfare variant of the Eurofighter multi-role fighter, designed for suppression of enemy air defense missions. It will be outfitted with transmitter location and self-protection equipment. Its armament will include 4 MBDA Meteor missiles, 2 Iris-T missiles, and 6 Spear EW weapons, along with 3 drop tanks, The two-seat variant will carry a mission specialist who will have access to dedicated electronic warfare and mission control screens. The German Air Force plans to upgrade 15 former single-seat Eurofighter jets to the EK standard starting in 2030. The Future Combat Air System FCAS. This is a collaborative European project involving Dassault Aviation, Airbus, Indra Systemas, and Thales Group. The FCAS fighter jets will replace current Francis Rafales, Germany's Typhoons, and Spain's EF-18 Hornets in the 2040s. These jets will be powered by two MTU Safran afterburning engines, each producing between 20,000 and 30,000 pounds of thrust, allowing for speeds of 1,243 miles per hour or Mach 1.6. A demonstrated test flight is anticipated around 2027, with operational deployment expected by 2040. Global Combat Air Program GCAP. This is a collaborative initiative that merges the BAE Systems Tempest and Mitsubishi FX projects. This aircraft will utilize advanced technologies such as artificial intelligence AI, machine learning, and autonomous systems to support both manned and unmanned flight. It will employ swarming technology to control drones and gather data from multiple sources. Operating stealthily, the aircraft will deliver comprehensive battlefield awareness and carry a substantial payload, including next-generation weaponry like directed energy weapons and hypersonic missiles. The first aircraft is expected to enter service in 2035. The Shenyang JXX. Shenyang Aircraft Corporation proposed the JXX, an aircraft larger than the J-20. The Chengdu J-20 also originates from the JXX program of the 1990s, and additional aircraft are expected to evolve from this program, according to sources. The JXX is generally conceptualized as a fifth-generation fighter, featuring stealth, supercruise, supermaneuverability, and short takeoff capabilities. Some of the proposed designs are believed to include features that enhance stealth and maneuverability while reducing weight and drag. The J-28, a prospective stealth fighter, was revealed through social media posts from China's military aviation industry, showcasing a series of concept art. This upcoming sixth-generation stealth aircraft is expected to have a tailless design. Similar to the US next-generation air dominance stealth fighter, details about the J-28 specifications are highly classified, keeping its features largely unknown. The F-8XX. US focused on developing and acquiring the 6th generation air superiority fighter to replace the US Navy's FA-18EF Super Hornet. As the Super Hornets approach the end of their 9,000-hour service life by the early 2030s, the FA-XX project aims to explore advanced technologies, potentially including comprehensive sensor connectivity and electronically adaptable smart skins. The F-8XX will be designed to support missile systems, incorporate power and cooling systems for directed energy weapons, and integrate sensors capable of targeting low-radar cross-section objects. The Next Generation Air Dominance NGAD. This program is the US Air Force's ambitious initiative to develop a sixth-generation fighter to succeed the F-22 Raptor. Expected to operate at altitudes between 20,000 and 22,000 meters and reach speeds around Mach 2.8, the NGAD is designed to surpass or match the F-22 in both altitude and speed. The aircraft may be equipped with AESA radar and is likely to include an infrared search and track system to detect enemy stealth aircraft through their heat signatures. For armament, the NGAD will probably feature the AIM-128 Joint Advanced Tactical Missile JATM, including the Modular Advanced Missile, LREW, LRAAM, Peregrine, CUDA, and Directed Energy Systems. Lockheed Martin SR-72, often called the son of Blackbird, this is an American hypersonic UAV designed for intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance. Proposed privately by Lockheed Martin in 2013 as a successor to the retired SR-71 Blackbird, The SR-72 was projected by company executives in 2018 to have a test vehicle in flight by 2025 and to enter service in the 2030s. The SR-72 is planned to feature an air-breathing hypersonic propulsion system capable of accelerating from Mach 6 from a standstill, making it roughly twice as fast as the SR-71. It is expected to be similar in size to the SR-71 at over 100 feet or 30 meters long and have a comparable range. While envisioned as an ISR and strike platform, specific payloads have not been detailed, likely due to the need for new sensors and weapons that can function effectively at Mach 6 and altitudes up to 80,000 feet or 24,400 meters. And with this, we're winding up for today, but stay tuned for more exciting videos from the Buzz. Stick around, guys, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.